I have with me Colonel H S Shankar. He is the head of Alpha Design Technologies, one of India's most innovative firms working in the area of space. You can see there are several rockets behind him. He works on satellites, on rockets, and several other things. Dr. Shankar, what is the key areas you're working on in helping India and ISRO?
We are in all the three segments of space. That is, firstly, go up to the space and then you see the satellites there. Then on the ground segment, you have the receivers, the antenna, receiving stations, the hub stations, the networking of all these antennas to give to the customer whatever that is desired. And for the satellite to go up, of course, you have the launchers. And so in all the three major areas of the space, our company is in the forefront now. And one of the organizations which has taken its stride and taken initiative for the past 4 to 5 years, and with tremendous cooperation from the very best of the organizations in our country, that is ISRO, with their, as we call in Hindi, Chhatra Chaya, we are progressing very well.
What is the most recent satellite you help integrate?
The recent one was just about 3 days old, that is GSAT-30. GSAT-30 is a 3.5 ton capacity communication satellite. It was completely done by our people, 70 people working, young people, who are in the age group of approximately 21 to 32. 50% of them were ladies, mind you. And they worked under the guidance and the support and the training from ISRO scientists at ISRO's facility called as ISITE, where the whole of the facilities was given to our boys and girls. And that was a very successful venture. And before that, of course, we had done the very, very successful GNSS 1I satellite. Which is the NavIC system to give the Indian GPS. And that is there up in the sky also. Of course, like a twinkle, twinkle little star and guiding us here. And so for the Indian GPS, it is the guiding star.
So how many satellites have you done in all now?
We have done three, and the fourth one has just been taken up, and that will be coming up, I think, in a very, very short period of time of another 4 months, because now our boys and girls have picked up as to how to do it well, how to do it fast, and how to do it of the highest quality. Again, thanks to our ISRO friends.
But can you do it without ISRO now?
You see, we can do it, but the fact is that it requires a lot of integration support, quality assurance support, and then the facilities that are needed. And so it is a gradual process. I think we are going towards it. Maybe in the next about 2 to 3 years period of time, it will be done. In fact, it has happened like that. The first satellite when we did, maybe our contribution was 50%. The second one, it was about 75%. In the GSAT-30, which we did recently, it may have been about 80%. So like that, it is a gradual improvement and gradual going up to a higher level, as would be the desire of ISRO. We would still like to work with our Gurujis of ISRO, because from there, every day you learn new things, and the system that is there, organized methodology of working, is something seen to be believed, and it's a good education for our youngsters.
We have rockets behind you. Now there's also a move to make the private industry do rockets. What is your involvement in that?
Yeah, we thought of getting into that. We were already doing a few of the important parts for the launchers. For example, in the Chandrayaan system, which has gone up for the moon mission, in that the rocket that was done, the top cone portion of it, the top cone was from our company, our own subsidiary company called as Alpha Tokol, and that is part of the GSLV-3. And we have been doing parts and subsystems and all that. Recently, ISRO had come out with a very, very ambitious scheme of coming out for making the complete PSLV through the private industry. They have come out with an expression of interest for making 5 PSLV, and they wanted this to be done in a consortium mode. And ourselves, we became a part of the consortium along with our new investor, that is Adani Group, and with Bharat Electronics as the head of the consortium, and BML is another consortium member. So three of us have participated along with another 4 similar consortiums. The ISRO has to take a decision as to whom all should be selected out of this, and on that basis we are sure that they will be placing the request for proposal, and whoever who wins in that would be the people who will be making the PSLVs in a large scale in the private sector.
So you're upbeat about India's space program and India's space industry?
Absolutely, we are upbeat, and the opportunities that is being given for the industries, whether it is private or public. And the best thing is that ISRO has made us work in a consortium mode. So there is a mutual cooperation, mutual giving and taking of technology, and then there is an ecosystem that has already been built which is being further exploited. So that is a plus point of the whole system that has been built up.
So that was Colonel Shankar for you, telling us that how Alpha Design Technologies is involved in making of satellites, is likely to get into the making of rockets, and essentially he is very upbeat about India's space program and India's space industry. In Bengaluru, Pallava, Bagla.